Piyasa, Gurdat, sorry. Gurdat, no?
Uh-huh.
Piyasa. I remember Piyasa, not Gurdat.
Piyasa.
And the same thing, you see, Madam Nityananda also has raised. Thesis, antithesis. Ta, tvam, ashi, synthesis. This is the essence. So about equality also, but right from the beginning, whether you see, it's only a norm. See, normative ought and existential peace, there is always no gap. After all, human yearning is to see that we have to achieve equality. And equality, in fact, see, if we go, as we may have to justify with several theories also, will it be really possible? Can we make absolutes possible? So absolutism has gone. In fact, see, if we go around this entire, see, all theories, see, after all, philosophy and science, there is practically not much difference. We may say science and philosophy and philosophy. After all, see, science is the daughter of philosophy. Philosophy, they go on searching for the truth. And as and when its object is established, it becomes no science. That's why Bertrand Russell, to make it very simple, he said, what we understand, what we know is science. What we do not know is philosophy. Simply said it. But we accept. So philosophy is that which is not attainable, but science is that where we get established. I mean, you may take some very strong positions. Take, for example, see, our friend, he was referring to Gandhi. And this conflict, in fact, 100 years ago, Gandhi faced in Champaran. The same problem which Antigone has faced 500 BC. When she has buried her brother, Horus, who died in the battle. The positive law said, you cannot bury these people, particularly those. And then she says, who are you? It's a human law made by you. I think I am not born by the human law. The divine law is eternal. It has come before you. It will live in after you also. And you see, I will be doing, you see, a great, blasphemous deed if I don't bury my brother. You may do whatever you like. The same conflict, right from the 5th or 6th century BC, till now it is going on, that the rift which is going on with the positive law and natural law. The entire story of law is nothing but a conflict between the positive law and natural law. And that's what exactly Gandhi also did. What is law of conscience? Law of conscience, what is law of conscience? See, section 144, as he was promulgated, particularly in Champaran. He was prohibited to enter the city for indigo workers. Then he said, I am just finishing this law. Because the human made law. Because conscience is something which is different, which again is can be related to reason. So what I think reasonable, I am just following that one. Therefore, this may go against you, but I am just trying to convince my own thing. And this again is a tempting reflection, self-critic of your reason. And this is how we see even the law, what is equal to you may not be equal to me. But then see, we arise this human rights aspect also. In fact, no, Kant also can be connected to human rights. Who is human rights? Who is human? And again, which part? As you said, West. West is not the, we see, human rights are not the gift of the West to the rest. They are universal. But now question is, universal truths are different. And once the human rights clash, the universality of human rights and the regions and indigenous people, cultural. The universal rights may be in conflict with the cultural rights or the minority rights. Let us take, for example, in African countries, this, the circumcision, among the Africans, it is their culture. But universality, because this, you cannot do this one. But then, see, universal right is a human right in conflict with regional right. It is here, see, Kant provides an answer. It is, you have to go for the common sense. Where is he trying to see what is common sense? And this Kant could not give, because common sense, of the entire group and common sense of the indigenous groups, I think they may clash. And for that purpose, now we see we can find answer. But Ramans is something we say again, here comes no morality. What is it? Many people accept as morality or morally right or conscientiously right. And for this purpose, we have to enter into a dialogue. Dialogue with the people. Don't go against some of those categorical or categorical imperatives. What the sovereign says is not as a final. Even that sovereign is, he has to be a benevolent sovereign. He must enter into a dialogue. This is what we see, democratic dialogues. And then you have to find out what is common good, what is public good. So here again, it can't fail. And people also should not get to see what is public justice. And then it's impact on not just say and say all these people they follow Ken and Arrow. Ken and Arrow.
He has to speak, na?
I'll refer, I'll explain tomorrow about Kenneth Arrow.
Yes.
Sure.
Oh, even let me tell you why I have come today here. Because I have to justify that I have earned my bread. Because all which has been talked here I don't know how to comment on that. And there was some problem of coordination. Okay. And as a result of which we have come at a time when to talk something very serious is a problem. But in any case, let me begin by saying two, three, and these are not performer. These are serious. Even though I'm talking at last moment, but these are the thoughts coming from my heart, coming from my mind, coming from my reasoning, coming from my emotion. And the first thought which I want to give is that none else in this country could have done, forget about this country, what has been talked here about Oriental jurisprudence, Orientalism. I don't think anybody other than Suri Prakash or Suri Kant could have done. I really, really compliment him, congratulate him. I have no words to register. In fact, I have lost my energy by now. Otherwise, I would have really used all kind of suffixes and prefixes which are somewhere in my mind. But despite of my loss of energy, I really salute him, congratulate him. And along with him, I really congratulate his mentor, that is Dr. Lakshminarayan. Because Lakshminarayan is one person who I'm doing his energy. Kant was in his syllabus. While to us, Kant did not mean anything. We learned much later, right? So I must congratulate these two persons. And along with these two persons, the entire team of Dr. Suri Prakash. In fact, I am only thanking and welcoming, right? I am not contributing. But two, three things I must say. I was very touched by your last remarks, Professor Lakshminarayan. And if you recall in Aurangabad, I started my speech with that. And what I said, common sense is though common, but it is very rare that you get common sense. And in fact, entire justice entire law, entire natural law school, including positive school, including of Stemler, which you were talking of in the morning, and forget about Stemler. After that, all Wenderheim and all these guys have come. They all have only said one thing, that law is common sense. But finding out common sense is too difficult. Tell me what we have been doing since morning. And therefore, common sense is a very rare commodity, right? We are all used to convert common into uncommon. We try to deal with uncommon. We don't want to be common, right? Modi ji ne kya kiya? Mere ko bandi pehni hai, lekin Nehru ki nahi pehni hai. Yahan lagana hai, gulab ka phool nahi lagana hai. Yahan kuch aur lagana hai. Lagate hain na? Kya hai? I have to become distinct. Because you have to become distinct, and therefore you can do anything. That's a one statement which came only from me. But in any case, whatever has been said today, there are three, four things which I will love to talk. Dr. Lakshmi, you talked a lot about transformative justice. And everybody since morning is talking of transformative justice. When you talk of transformation, what is the meaning of transformation? And remember, each one of you in your own ways has something, said something like this, that Immanuel Kant was talking in a context. Each one of you have said, and even I say, that he was talking in a context, and now to understand him in the present context is doing injustice to him or justice to him. Remember, you read hard laws. And in hard laws, you have some test called reasonableness, called contemplation. You know, you all say what a reasonable man can contemplate. Let's not be unreasonable. Let's not be uncommon. Let's be only reasonable. As a reasonable person, if I put Mr. Kant into position of a reasonable person of today, what would have he contemplated? That is the question. And this question has to be answered, as Nirmala Madam said, as Pyasa Gurdat Saab said, as Patil Saab said, and to answer this question is not an easy joke. 23 years ago, that is, I'm talking of 1976, the then President of America goes to Berlin. And what he says, he invites Brezhnev. And what he says, let us build this wall. Do you remember what I'm talking about? Henry Kissinger was considered to be a very brutal fellow. Entire America hated him. Entire America said, look, he's spending so much on defense. He's violating human rights everywhere. He's bringing bad name to America. Somewhere he's sending 7th Fleet. somewhere he's doing this, somewhere he's doing that. They did not help him at all, and they considered China as their greatest enemy. Lakshminarayan, you know how the American Supreme Court, I'm talking of American Supreme Court, I'm talking of justice, how the American Supreme Court itself became party to curb the communism, right? And now what happened is, same Kissinger, one day there came the news that the plane with which he was flying is missing. Now, entire America got shocked. Despite they did not like him, they had all prayers in the churches, they all had all kind of meeting, and they all started praying to God that somewhere he is found and somewhere he is safe. After about a week, again came the news that the president of America, his plane is also missing. Now America got blocked. And then what they find? Next morning when they get up, at that only CNN was available. Okay. And it was available only in that part of the world. When they switch on, they see American president, they see Kissinger, and they see Brezhnev. All three in Moscow. Entire America was shocked that what has happened. They have gone to our enemy. Not only they have gone to our enemy, and they are raising the hand. Is it a blackmail? Were they kidnapped? Have they had some, like Kandahar, has some bargain has taken place? No. Then come back Kissinger and American president, and they tell to entire America that we went, we had a secret parley, we had a summit meeting, and now we are going to break this Berlin. NATO, SATO will go, Bonn, Berlin will become one. The East Europe, which was living in tatters, where there was hunger, there was everything not available, people were dying of health crisis. Now that part will become part of Germany. Now I'm talking of 23 years ago, September 19. I remember that date, September 19, 1976, this statement came. And now I want to ask, the same American president is saying what? I'm sad. Let me not give you help me. Same American president, the president of the same country, is now saying what? Not breaking the wall. He's talking of making the wall. He said, you give me text because I want to construct a wall between US and Mexico, right? And what is, he went to the extent of American government closing down, because in America there is a law, and that law says that if the executive wants to exercise veto on something, right, and the Senate does not agree, then there will be government lockdown. And the government was locked down, people were not paid their salary, energies were closed, entire Michigan had a dark night because the government was closed. And why? Because please mark the context in which who? Emmanuel Kant gave his thesis 1729, and now I am talking of the context. What context? Context is completely changed. And forget that. I'm talking of recent. 1990, at least you will agree, so far as India is concerned, 1990 is what happened? Globalization.
Yes.
Right? And what you said, entire world is one market. Entire world is one market. WTO, World Bank, IMF, ADB, these are all financial institutions of the world. We are all member of this. And we are all abide by this. That is why India had to sell gold. I don't want to go to those niceties because it's a sidetrack, right? Because I really want to talk theoretical tomorrow. This is a sidetrack, but it's very relevant. Now what happened? 1990, you have no tariff, no duty. If you impose duty, you are violating the entire global legal system which was coming. European Union had come, and now what happened? Today what is happening? What is happening? There is a big fight between America and China. What is that? There is a big fight between India and China. There is a big crisis between India and America. And please mark what world you are talking of. What world Emmanuel Kantor is talking of. You know, what is happening in Hong Kong? What is happening in Hong Kong? The entire Muslim population called where? Can you believe tractors are put on their chest and they are killed. They are killed and mined. Now what America does? America passes a law, a positive law. Positive law, a normative law. American Congress passes an act. I'm calling the word ACT. Act of 2019. And what is the act which will be enforced in 2020 January? What is the act? That act says that the kind of human rights violation China is doing in Hong Kong, if it is not prevented, if it is not controlled by China, then America will impose all kind of sanctions on. Now China, who you are? What are you talking? Two things. One, you are challenging that we are violating human rights. What about you? You have violated human rights, be it Poland, be it Burkina Faso. You violated human rights all over the world. And you are the one who is saying what? I will stop giving fund to UN. You are the one who is saying what? This United Nations Human Rights Commission is a bogus thing. You went and spoke against it. Now you are talking of human rights. In China, number one. Number two, what do you talk? International community comprises of sovereign. And one sovereign cannot interfere into another sovereign. Now, what kind of thing you are talking? You are passing a law interfering in my sovereignty. And therefore, what is this nonsense you are doing? You are only telling because you have got money, because you have might, and therefore you are right. Are you getting my point? Now, when the context is changing so much, then to expect that Emmanuel Kant will talk of those many categories, you know, because so much was talked here about categories, right? It's not possible for him to talk of those categories. And I'm talking of what test? Applied test of reasonable contemplation. Even if you give him status of a reasonable man, then he would have contemplated, and he was not a judge. He was, a very wrong impression had been created by him. And I was talking to my good friend Umesh last night. Everywhere I think you people know more than me, because my generation was still very more still blessed, because we did not have too much enmities amongst ourselves. We still live for equality. We still had some sense of respect for each other. Like if I have to say, making this kind of thing like civilized signal. But despite of that, remember, human nature is human nature. And that is why he gave you the whole idea of social contract. I will talk of social contract tomorrow, but I am relating here in a different way. Social contract means what? I want to live together. Yeah. What is human nature? We all want to live together. Don't you think many times we say, sir, therefore, if somebody is a guy, he does set up a therefore, right? What you are saying, don't put me into solitary confinement. It is better you hang me, because loneliness kills. Loneliness kills. And remember, on the other side, there is a contradictory attribute which every human being possesses. That is, I'm ready to kill you, provided I can save myself. It happens. I guess not. Contradiction. What is contradiction? I want to live with you. But at the same time, if need arises, I will suck your blood, because that suits me. And as a result of which, what happened? As a civilization grew, people realize that we require some mechanism to control this. Are you getting my point? And therefore, what do you do? You give rise to state. And with state, you enter into a contract. What contract? I will surrender a part of liberty of mine. Okay? You can put me in jail. You can hang me if you think I am a danger to the social existence. That was a social contract. Right? And what happened? Poor fellow, Emmanuel Kant, was facing a similar kind of situation. That on one side, people were really saying, you know, when he died, and when his coffin was dead, the temperature was minus 24, because he was living in a town where you had all through the year the snow, and that is the coldest part of the world. 24, and as a result of which, they could not construct a pyre for him for one week, because his body was completely frozen. It was very difficult for them to dig the pyre. It's only after a week this all happened. And that town had hardly 3,000 houses, and despite of that, there were about 12,000 people who joined his funeral, and many of them did not know. They had only heard he was a great philosopher, he was a great man, and they wanted to see how does his corpus look like. And some of them were having greater anxiety, because they thought one whose corpus had been preserved for 1 week, how his corpus should be looking. And therefore, there was a big crowd. And unfortunately, same problem which I am coming to. There were few people within the community of philosophers. आपका कॉम्पिटिटर कौन होगा? आपका टीचर होगा ना? और तो कोई होगा नहीं. क्या हुआ? The community of philosophers is saying there were two, three philosophers who could not say openly that it not like it, or who could not openly say that he was absolutely wrong, but they definitely wanted to dig holes in it. And therefore what they did, they said, ये जो एम्बुल टैंक है ना, इसमें बहुत ही आइसोलेटेड लाइफ लीड की है, बहुत आइसोलेटेड वर्क किया है, तो इसको एक क्रेडिट तो देना पड़ेगा. और क्या क्रेडिट देना पड़ेगा? That he was non-adulterated. Please mark what is the language here. No, this language is very dangerous. Very. He is non-adulterated. He has not been impured by anything. Pure theory of Kelsen. What happened? He used to walk, my wife, Dr. Mrs. Parma Sharma. She and I talked of this episode one night at 2 o'clock. She got mad. I made her wake up at 2 in the morning. I said, आपने मुझे कुछ बताया था कि वो आदमी अकेला सड़क पर घूमता था. हाँ. तो पहले तो मैंने कहा सुबह बात. I said, no, I have something important to talk to you. In any case, she woke up. Herself is a scholarly mind person. So I asked कि आपका क्या कहना है कि वो अकेला क्यों घूमता था? आपने मुझे ये बताया कि लोग वॉच मिला लेते थे. आज डॉक्टर सूर्यकांत के बारे में बोला गया कि 10 बजे का मतलब 10 बजे. याद है लक्ष्मीनाथ जी कि वॉच मिला. तो हमने इनसे पूछा कि ऐसा सब क्यों? आप देखिए यही जवाब. क्या जवाब मिलेगा? आई एम गोइंग टू माई ऑफिस इन द यूनिवर्सिटी. हाउ मेनी टाइम्स आई विल हैव टू चेंज मेट्रो? हाउ मेनी टाइम्स आई विल हैव टू चेंज बसेस? हाउ मेनी धक्का मुक्की आई विल हैव टू डू, राइट? एंड हाउ मच आई विल हैव टू कवर माई नोज एंड माय माउथ बिकॉज पोल्यूशन इज देयर. देन अल्टीमेटली आई रीच देयर. And once I reach there, I will have to take some coffee. Now, do I make coffee? Is the milk available? And if the milk is not available, is some peon available? And peon or godfather in here? Right? Now tell me, how many disruptions do I have? And therefore, what is critics told? Non-adulterated. Every day thinking only on one thing, what is metaphysics? And therefore, he could give you a reality, but which is very narrow. Which is very narrow. Now that is a criticism, which is very narrow. They are wrong. You will be surprised that there was a big literary movement. Doctor, you and I were together in Salzburg. In Salzburg, there was this great musician. What is the name?
Mozart.
Like Mozart's literary, he could give a very different culture. Mozart could invent a very different culture. Similarly, in Germany, there was a literary movement in those days going on, which was called Sondheim. This was Sondheim. And can you believe it is ever can, who was the most active member, rather the founder member of that literary movement, and every evening he will go and attend the music every day. That means it is not that he did not know life. Not only this, you know, on his thinking there was a great impact of French Revolution and American Civil War. You know, he was leading the life at the time when Civil War was taking place in America and when French Revolution, and what was French Revolution? Individualism. And what was American Civil Revolution? Social justice. That sabhay nahi hoga. Are you getting my point? And therefore, all these things were definitely very important for him, because context, mind, he changed according to context. And today also he would have changed according to that context. I'll say only two, three things and I'll shut up my mouth. One, whatever has been said today, from morning till evening, I will have to do 3 points. One, what he said was, everyone has a right. I'm using the word capital right. Everyone has a right to do right. My second right is smaller. I can't go there, otherwise I could have written. What he said, everyone has right to do right. What do you mean by this? Everyone has right to do right. If I have only one duty, that duty is, please mark, and you finish with Gandhi, okay? What he said, every human being has only one duty, and that duty comprises of his right. I have a right, as a duty. I have a duty to exercise my right. You are none to tell me that you exercise right or you don't exercise right. I have a duty to exercise my right to do right. What do you mean? To do right. That means I should not do anything wrong. I have a duty to perform my right to do right. And that is where whole natural law school of thought will come, that if I have to do right and if I have not to do wrong, then what? Initially you said, you apply your mind, you will come to know what is right, what is wrong. Then you said, divine will tell what is right and what is wrong. Then you said, Dharma Chakra will tell you what is right and what is wrong. Are you getting my point? And therefore, be it the king, be it the pauper, whoever it is, has only one duty to perform, that is right to do right. Right? And that is why Gandhi said, that though my mother was illiterate, but she taught me that a duty performed well is the achievement of mind. He said, whenever you are in doubt, imagine before you a person who is in need, who has wants, and then answer to yourself, had you been in his position, what would have been your answer? And you will find. Tell me, kya bole? मंदिर से आया है प्रसाद, गिरजाघर से आया है प्रसाद, मस्जिद से आया है सेवैया, भैया मेरे लिए न गॉड मस्जिद में बसता है, न मेरे लिए गॉड अजायब घर में बसता है, न मेरे लिए गॉड मंदिर में बसता है, मेरा गॉड तो ये सिवैया ही है, मेरा गॉड प्लीज मान दैट इज वेयर सोशल जस्टिस का, दैट इज वेयर सोशल जस्टिस का, दैट व्हाट ही सेड राइट इज अ ड्यूटी टू परफॉर्म दैट राइट एंड टू देयर आर थ्री टू व्हेन यू से योर ड्यूटी टू डू राइट then also a lot of reference has been given here to preamble, right? Right from my friend Mukesh to Lakshminaji to Monty to Vibhutesa, everybody has said. Now, there is a word, and what word? Justice, political, social, economic, equal dignity, right? Now, like I said, right to do right, similarly I will say, just freedom. You don't require anything, you require just freedom. What do you mean by just freedom? Freedom, what are you saying? I require freedom of speech, I require freedom of expression, I require freedom to know, I require freedom to have information. Whole RTI has come only on this, right? Whatever you say, freedom of speech, freedom of expression, freedom of faith, freedom of belief, freedom of the kind of worship I want to make. You are talking of freedom. I am adding one more, that is just. What do you mean by just freedom? That is where Kant will become very important in today's context.
Limits.
Just freedom means what?
Limits.
I will exercise my freedom in a just manner. Just means what? Through my nose and your nose. Right? No, I will exercise my freedom in a manner that it is just to you. Just to you, meaning thereby your freedom will be equally protected as my freedom. And that is why social contract, that is why reasonable restriction. Are you getting my point? Why reasonable restriction? Because otherwise, I being a human, I have a tendency to grab more and more and more and more. I will ask my wife to give me tea early in the morning. Once she has given me the tea, then I will say, I require a second cup also. Then after, what will I say? Look, take out my clothes also. I don't know. Mine. Because she is obliging me, I am asking more and more and more. And more power corrupts more. Right? And that is why what they say, just freedom. Just freedom means that much freedom of mine should be protected by the system. Sovereign must protect my that freedom. Institutions must protect my that freedom. Processes must protect my that freedom. Why do you have this new process? Why did you come out with this Menka's jurisprudence when you said due process? Due process means what? What is due to me should be given to me, but what is due to me cannot be undue to me. Therefore, please mark. Then comes the third thing, that once you do right, what is right, Once you exercise your freedom in just manner, then comes the third issue. That is, in change context, in today's context, when, do you know what is the position of India today? On Human Development Index, we have gone one up. But on Human Hunger Index, we have gone down. And we have gone down to the extent that my neighbor, Pakistan, I'm particularly saying Pakistan, Bangladesh, Afghanistan. I'm mentioning Dr. Mukesh, these countries with a purpose, because Amit Shah is also facing a sanction. You remember, if they pass a law and they say that China will be sanctioned, Jai will be sanctioned, only last week they have passed a resolution, not a law, resolution. And under that resolution, what they have said, whatever you are doing in the name of CAB, whatever you are doing in the name of NCR, you will be sanctioned if you do not correct your own ways. And you know what does sanction mean? Modi had to face sanction. You recall Modi had to face sanction. And when he had to face sanction, he was not given visa. That is why Modi is very smart. Once he became the Prime Minister, he gave all impetus to diaspora. Why? Because he do politics. What politics? If diaspora is with me, they will have to vote. They will have to support. What has happened in UK yesterday? UK, what has happened yesterday? Entire Labour Party lost. And Conservative won. Labour Party is a party which gave you the freedom, which gave you the independence. Labour Party is a party which has always supported India. But what happened? No, this time we supported Conservative because Labour Party, unfortunately for them, they passed a resolution, and in that resolution they said, we are concerned about violation of human rights in Kashmir Valley and we would like India to take corrective measures. This resolution itself deflected Indian population from them. And yesterday, and you know this, what is his name? Imran Khan. He himself had gone to London to lobby for votes for the Labour Party. And he convinced lakhs of people from all over the world. They had come there. Muslim population, because they wanted to the election, and the result was very different. And therefore, what I'm saying is, it is very, very important that in today's context, this game of he was talking of multiculturalism, right? This game where multiculturalism is being destroyed. I will not give you visa because you are this Islamophobia, right? That has to be. I'm not saying right or wrong. Not because, see, somewhere I've written, I don't have time, that's my crisis. Entire world, European Parliament has passed a law, European Parliament has passed a resolution, American Congress has passed a resolution, American Senate has passed a resolution, Canadian has passed a resolution, Australian has passed a resolution, Turkey has passed a resolution, Malaysia has passed a resolution. there are 29 countries who have passed a resolution against India. And only on one issue, what they are saying, Abdullah ko chodo, kam se kam wo to three times chief minister tha, दो टाइम यूनियन मिनिस्टर था, अब राज्यसभा का मेंबर है, अब लोकसभा का मेंबर है और श्रीनगर से मेंबर है। हाँ, हाउ कैन यू डिनाई ए लोकसभा मेंबर टू कम एंड पार्टिसिपेट ऑन द फ्लोर ऑफ द हाउस। उसके बाद अमित शाह भी छोड़ रहे हैं, ठीक है, गलत कर रहे हैं, ह्यूमन राइट्स वायलेट हो रहा है, पार्लियामेंट्री प्रिविलेज वायलेट हो रहा है, ये तो एक साइड स्टोरी है, बट लेट अस नॉट फॉरगेट द सेकंड साइड। व्हाट इज द सेकंड साइड स्टोरी? सेम फारूक अब्दुल्ला ऑन 3rd and 4th of August meets मोदी हियर इन दिल्ली, गोज बैक देयर एंड गिव्स अ टीवी इंटरव्यू। And what is a TV interview? India should learn. Otherwise, if anything happened to 370, we will go to the other side. Mind, this is a speech which he gave. What speech? That other 370 should be retained. And if it is not retained, we will have no hesitation to join the other side. This is Mufti Mahbooba. You know what statement she gave? She gave a statement where she said that it will be very difficult for an Indian hand. Please mark. It will be very difficult for an Indian hand to hold a flag. That means what she was saying. Right? And therefore, the game is not so easy. This is the paradox. That on one side, they appear to be right. On the other side, these appear to be right. An American becomes so relevant here because, as a reasonable person who is interested in peace, prosperity, happiness, we will do what? Strike a balance. But striking a balance is not a it's not a joke. But that is there. You and I cannot take liberty. Please mark, you and I, you can still take liberty because you can do whatever you want to do.